Now that you've been able to do a few student broadcasts, it's time to up your game. This week, your assignment is to replace a green screen behind the talent with a virtual set. And for bonus points, you can add in some virtual image in the foreground. This is not difficult, but can easily improve the quality of your broadcasts. Let me show you how this is done. First of all, you want to make sure to turn on the overhead LED light. This will light the back of the green screen. Try to get out any wrinkles in the screen that you can, and then let me show you on the computer how to set this up. Here's the setup inside of Wirecast, how to get rid of the green screen and replace it with a virtual background and a virtual foreground. You can see here how the layers sandwich the camera shots, and then the person sits in between these two layers. So if I were to switch over, I'm literally walking in between the foreground and the background. That's why the camera is placed in between the foreground, which is in front, and the background, which is down below. We now need to set up the chroma key inside of our camera shots. To do that, you select the camera shot that you're going to use. Click on the two arrows to open up the settings, and we're going to click on the icon that looks like a person. We're then going to choose Use Chroma Key. This instantly takes out whatever image that was there that was green. I'm going to uncheck that. You can see the green here. Even though the camera is going in and out of focus, it's because there's no person in the scene for the camera to focus on. We're simply going to use Chroma Key. If it comes up and it's not working correctly, you can choose to adjust the threshold and the backlit. If I adjust these, it changes the quality of the green screen and how much is being removed. In this case, the defaults seems to work pretty well. Go ahead and select both cameras and do this for both of them. Once you have both cameras set up, we need to add in a background, which will go beneath us, and a foreground, which will go in front of us. Click on the plus in a circle, go down to Media File. I'm going to choose the Computer Lab. Click Open. When I have this picture open, notice how it doesn't fill the frame completely. I select that shot, I click on my settings, and I can bring the scale up. And I can, Command-Z if you make a mistake, I can select the shot. There we go. Make sure that you deselect other shots, and I can move this shot where I want it to be. In this case, I'm going to position it right about here. I can see what the shot looks like with my chairs in front of it. Now to add a foreground, I simply click on the plus. Again, I go to Media File. I'm going to change my folder to Foreground. In this case, I'm going to use a teacher table. This obviously is too big, but I can click and I can move it around, or I could scale it to a different size that I want it to be. In this case, I think it'll look good, something like this. I have now created my foreground shot. I have chroma keyed or taken out the green of my camera shots, and I have put in a background shot. If I were to switch these all over, I press the space bar, it switches to the live. I now have my three shots sandwiched together. You can see the camera's kind of going in and out. I think I'm going to use this camera actually. So I switch cameras because this one zoomed in more on one shot. Now if I go and sit in the shot, you will notice that I'm in between the shots. But when I sit down and the camera focuses on me, it looks pretty good. You can see the virtual background and the virtual desk in front of me. For your first assignment, all you have to do is change the background. Next week, if you want to get more creative and change a foreground and put a virtual set in the front as well, you're welcome to do that. But for this assignment, simply change the green screen, put it somewhere else, and make sure that you have permission to use the background image that you're using for your virtual set. Good luck. I look forward to seeing your broadcasts this week.